coaches. He's a schoolboy football. A team could rise and a team could fall, but they never will know until the whistle blows around. Come enjoy the show. He's a
We just saw exciting football here on your home of champions between St. George's College and Jose Marti. But we have more in store for you with Campion College versus Arden High. Some may call it the Uptown Derby. I know for sure my commentary team of Donald Oliver and Leger Williams will have some fun banter with that. So they'll be taking you through 90 minutes and I will be seeing you soon.
Heaven knows about the banter that Janae Robinson speaks of, but let's take a look at the Zone F fixtures and results so far. St. George's College with a 7-2 victory, of course. If you're just joining our coverage, you would have missed that encounter. And just to show you that St. George's College, they lead the standings on 21 points from their 7 matches played. Campion College and Arden High, they're about to play their 7th match. Campion with 13 points, Arden on 3. So a bit of a gap between both teams. And we anticipate an interesting matchup in a few minutes' time. Leger Williams, a former Campion College, I was going to say standout, but I'm not sure if that's going to be a bit of a stretch, but definitely a standout in my book as far as being one of the top young analysts in the country. Leger Williams, how are you doing?
Good save, Donald. I'm doing pretty well. Looking forward to this game. Always nice to see those occasions that Campion are favored in a football game, and that's what we're going to be looking forward to now. Campion College, it's an under-16 urban champions last season. A lot of that team returning now to play in this game, in this under-19 season, facing off against Arden, who have been struggling this season. Campion College, I think, with a win today, can advance from the group or shore up their advancement from the group for the second consecutive season after missing out for close to 30 years from advancing. So, a lot on stake for Campion, a lot at stake for Arden as well, looking to have some pride in this season. A lot of the crowd has dissipated from Winchester Park ahead of this clash, but a lot of intrigue in this game still remains from this commentary area all the way around Hope Road and its environs.
And of course, off Hope Road would be one Arden High School. On Arden Road, that's Campion College in their typical red. There are the famous world-renowned colors of Arden High, blue and yellow. And we'll now pause for the playing of the national anthem here at Winchester Park. Warm conditions all around us as we prepare for this battle between Arden and the Campion.
Skippers, each other for a minute, please. Play a game of football, want to enjoy football as possible, all right? You have spectators, entertain them. Good? That's why they are here. They have to sit home and we improve the team. Good? So play nice, clean football and make a better team win. All right? Good? Your own team. We have 23 and we have Adidas. Call in here from your team.
Adidas.
What do you say? And that's what means they win, alright?
Go on this
side. So right. Switch side.
This side, switch side. Alright, so you're gonna have ball. Alright, Ed listen in. Alright? Ed, enjoy the game.
Brilliant.
Let's take a look at the lineup for Campion College. Alex James between the sticks. They're going with a back five of Asher Harrison, Marquise Steele, Brandon Muhammad, Jaden Morgan and Ethan Brown, Elijah White and Nikolai Banton in the middle of the park. Banton from Barbados. And Jazz Less, the number 10, will be behind Matthew Rule and Matthew Lloyd.
Yeah, this Campion team, they play in a myriad of formations. Expect to see a lot of rotation in between their ranks. Let's see how Arden will line up to cope.
Well, let's see. They will go with a 4-3-3 formation. Josh Adlam is in between the sticks. Ravain Bell, Javon Jackson, Romain Foster, and David Akanbi, the back four. Sean Reed, Alessandro Doshi, and Brandon Banton in the middle of the park. While Denzel Allen, Shaquille McDaniel, and Nashawn Reed will lead the line for Arden High.
Yeah, Arden lining up in a 4-3-3 formation. They're looking to get the ball from back to front as quickly as possible. Look out for Doshi in the midfield. He'll be looking to be their main architect.
And we're underway here at Winchester Park. Arden High with the kickoff. They'll be kicking towards North Street. Well, Campion College will be kicking towards the Crossroads area. It'll be interesting to see the type of matchup that will play out here.
Open.
Campion College, well, they have lost quite a few players, you know, and their star players from last year, they have gone overseas to further their education. They were just, what, 14 and 15? And they were the top players for Campion College last year. We're talking about young Kai Mills and Brian Mayhew. Kai Miles, sorry, not Mills. Kai Miles and Brian Mayhew. And, they're not there anymore. And there is some indication that a few of the players in the Campion College squad, they have such lofty ambitions that they don't anticipate to be in our school system for long. And they're not even moving primarily because of football. It's just straight academic. Imagine saying that you can do better than Campion College.
I think it's just to line themselves up for more opportunities abroad.
Well, here's an opportunity for Campion now. Flag stays down. Ball put across the area, but Arden High, they have enough defenders back. It's a very young team, Campion. They have about two players in the starting lineup, 14 years old. As we take a look at the man in charge here, Ashton Blankson.
Yeah, a man who has really revolutionized or helped to revolutionize the Campion football program. One of the founding coaches in the Kingston Football Academy, which many of these players are a part of, just helped to develop the program to a point where they can compete at the Manning Cup level, as well as I mentioned earlier, winning the under 16 competition last season.
Ball over the top, and keeper comes out, doesn't do enough, but the flag goes up and the whistle on the play. So what is it, a penalty that's been awarded?
I'm not quite sure what the decision is, but there is no goal and the Campion players are walking away. Okay. But there is a penalty, actually. Not quite sure for what. Would love to see the replay before Nikolai Banton, it looks like, steps up to take this one.
Yeah, Banton looking to register his first goal this season. Steps up to shoot and scores. Convincing kick in the fourth minute of play. Campion College, they take the lead. And their number 18 registering from 12 yards here. And Campion with the advantage early.
Yeah, we're going to see what caused the penalty to be given in the first place here. That doesn't make it any more clear, but they did have a fair goal chalked off and then they got a penalty to score one either way. And that's what was done. The only thing that the goal wasn't given in the end to Matthew Lloyd. This one was given to Nikolai Banton instead for him to score actually his second goal of the season. The Barbados under 15 international. And in the early doors, Campion up 1-0 over Arden. Campion, another team that, for all their talents, have scored a lot of goals this season in this group. This is their seventh game, and that was only their 12th goal, operating at less than two goals a game, that in a group that contains Pembroke Hall, who has conceded some massive scores so far this season. But their strength has been their defense, a defense which has only allowed two goals, both of them coming to St. George's in one game.
Lloyd Terry Long is the man in charge of Arden High. Would have been part of that successful Arden team of 1991, winning the Manning Cup then.
Yeah, the school spirit must have been extremely high around that time, Donald.
Yeah, I wasn't there. But the Reverend Glenn Archer would have been manager. The late Reverend Glenn Archer would have been manager of the Arden High School football team at that time. Of course, he's more renowned for guiding outstanding spelling bee champions as well as or unrivaled school challenge quiz teams.
Yeah, I see that you're drawing for academics now. I won't get into that one. Let's just focus on what's happening on the football field.
Well, I could also talk about basketball as well and netball and how dominant Arden High has been in those sporting disciplines, but I will not. So there's a free kick for Arden over on that far side. It is going to be a long afternoon, is it?
Yeah, I mean for you.
Billy, step right. Step right, Billy.
Arden with an opportunity here.
Yeah, will they be able to get back in this one? That's not a bad looking kick at all, you know. And that was a relatively free header that he couldn't quite connect with.
His team
rising highest there inside the box. And Denzel Allen looking for his first goal this season. Couldn't quite redirect the header.
Yeah, his teammate was right behind him looking to line up a bicycle kick. Alessandro Doshi. Spent last season at York Castle.
That's a famous Arden tie. As some sixth formers have come across from Arden Road to support the team. Would be a little bit disappointed with the scoreline at the moment.
I think they'll continue to be disappointed for the rest of this game. Campion playing out from the back here.
And they've lost it. Arden with the opportunity here to try and get back level. Couldn't supply the pass, which was necessary in that position. And the delivery a bit overcooked. But Campion College doing enough for the throw deep in their own half.
Just less, a little bit too powerful. Hard to miss with those twists, Jazz. Sandra Doshi will be the one swinging this one in. I think if anything is going to come good for Arden, he'll be at the source of it.
Your lock up, do not open wide.
Yeah. Well, here's a kick towards the keeper who does enough. And here's an effort from outside the area going over the top.
From the back confidently.
Yeah, let's see what they can do in transition here. That's a lovely ball on that left hand side. Arden trying to recover it, unable to do so. Here's a shot from distance, stung the keeper and the defense with the clearance, but Campion College still trying to press. It's another red wave trying to move forward. That was a poor choice to try and make his way through the two players there, but here they come again, Campion. But Arden with enough back. Here's an attempt, and he goes down low to collect. Good save there by the custodian, Adlam.
Campion really turning on the pressure these past couple minutes. Well done by Marquis Steele to shepherd that one out. A lot of fluidity, as I mentioned, in this Campion formation. Hard to pin down an exact one. More so a lot of spatial awareness. And I think that has been the strength of this Campion team these past couple seasons, especially in this one without a recognizable attacker. The absence of Kai Miles, a lot of positional rotation, something that we see from a lot of Europe's elite being implemented here. It has been beneficial to guiding this young team.
Well, Kempert again in the attacking third, again looking to utilize their numbers. Another attempt. Oh, just throw them on the park right now with a shot and block. Back and forth on that occasion.
That one.
Les plays it forward, and Matthew Lloyd couldn't quite keep the pace of that one just right. hopeful ball played forward. Arden trying to transition. Sean Reed. Reed on his left foot. Ball played inside. There's a slight appeal for a handled ball there, but nothing doing. Akanbi. Now the ball goes the other way. Lovely takedown by Rule. Flag went up for offside though.
I'm going to see a replay of the penalty incident here. Seems as if the referee did see a hand, but that hand was firmly pressed against the chest of the defender. Definitely not a penalty in my book. I think Donald would share the same sentiments. But as I said, all's well that ends well, because the referee did chalk off a goal to give the penalty, and the penalty was converted. So a goal in the end was the conclusion. And that's the goal that Campion lead by right now.
Still not sure what the referee would have seen. Has to be careful at the back there. He's under pressure. Being helped out in the end by the Cadby. Arden, they're looking for a free kick, but the ball inside the area, the keeper spilt it. And he's on the turf and will need some attention now. John Adlam.
I think that's a sticky one. Both players had every right to go for it. That was a meaty collision.
The torso of Adlam just going into the striker's shoulder there. So probably just got the wind knocked out of him a little bit. Players taking a bit of a break because it's necessary as well. Although this is the unofficial break. Feeling a little bit sore, Adlam, after that collision. Finding it difficult to get up.
It's not often that you see the keeper being the one that comes off worse in those situations. That's certainly the case on this occasion, however. Slower pace in this game than in the first one, might say. At this stage, Georges were about to score their fourth goal in their contest against Jose Marti. The other Zone F game that happened right before this one, Georges ended up winning 7-2. Campion looking to pass out that Jose Marti team and go into second position in the group with a win here. And they're already in a good position to do so. 1-0 up against Arden.
The average age of this Campion College squad is about 15 years. It was mentioned before that it's difficult for Campion College to try and build a dynasty because so many of their players matriculate long before they reach 18 at times.
And we saw evidence of that last season. Two of their standout players, Kai Miles and Brian Mayhew. Players that helped them to get to the second round in the Manning Cup, get to the quarterfinals of the Walker Cup, and win the under-16 competition. Both of them leaving before the age of 16 to greener or newer pastures. Don't want to say greener.
Here's an opportunity for Arden. Twisting and turning is Banton. Plays it out wide. Reed. Back inside. And was that deflected? Yep, it was. Corner kick.
Arden looking to go the long route to scoring. It's a red wall in front of them anytime they approach the box.
They haven't been afraid to take shots from distance as Adlam goes down again, and I'm not sure how long he'll be able to continue, or at least he needs a little bit more time to recover.
Yeah, it is away from play, so you do make a good point if he will be able to recover.
They do have another goalkeeper on the bench. Arden High in Chipweze Nwokocha. But I think he's good to go, Adler. Not the first time we are hearing that name in schoolboy football, Adlam. Corner kick to Arden High, looking for the equalizer here. Wasn't the best delivery. Wasn't the most convincing clearance either. And here they're finding it difficult to get out of their own penalty area. Here's a chance that goes skywards.
Short goal kick by Campion there. It's a player from the back.
Yeah, they do love the passing game, Campion College.
A lot of players comfortable in that aspect. Not the best choice there. Want to progress play a bit too quickly. There's Doshi.
Yeah. They themselves trying to transition, but they don't necessarily push a lot of players forward.
Nikolai Banton winning a free kick there.
Yeah. So, free kick to Campion College. Can they get a second one here? The wall has been set up. Three players inside that wall, which is constructed. They have committed six players inside the box. Arden, this one is sent into the wall. A deflection. Les trying to reach there. Here they come again. Ball dinked inside the area. Matthew Rule will get the corner kick for his team. Adlam paying keen attention here. And over his head, over everybody's.
Yeah, a bit too much on that one from Rule. As we go into the first water break.
Yeah, the players don't mind. Adlam doesn't mind. He still needs some treatment, I think. I was mentioning that it's not the first time you'd hear that, you'd have heard that name at the schoolboy football level. John Adlam. Remember Alonso Adlam from Excelsior was one of those outstanding midfielders. Went to play for Portman United as well. Did Adlam after representing Excelsior. But John Adlam has already been in the wars here, and we hope it's nothing too serious. Although I guarantee if it was serious or it had anything to do with a rib being fractured, he wouldn't have found any comfort in walking at all. Those things are painful.
And emerging first from their huddle. It is still a hot day here at Winchester Park. Adlam needing more treatment on his midsection. Arden stopper. Coaching staff talking things over, how they can get back into this game. So far only one win for Arden this season, scoring six goals, now conceding 22, second to last in this group. Pretty similar to their group standing from last season, where they scored 7, conceded 31. But towards the end of last season, they did win their last 3 games without conceding a goal. So that would have provided some hope coming into this season that really hasn't translated so far. Let's see what they can turn around here for the remainder of this game.
Arden. Trying to grow in confidence after going behind. Elijah White, who's a captain, plays it long, or tries to. Easy does it for Campion. Mistakes galore.
Yeah, there's another. Campion looking to be patient in their build-up. Hasn't been too crisp the last 15 minutes or so. Jazzless looking to change that, takes a shot.
Yeah, and the save is made. Moving low to his left on the side that still hurts. And Adlam is even in more pain.
Yeah, this is brave goalkeeping, but I think at some point he needs to think about his own well-being. It was a good save in the end. It was arrowing away from him. But he has earned Campion a corner. Will be Banton to swing this one in.
This is what, the third time he's down now? Same injury? Whether he's aggravating it or. Well, what else? He's getting treatment for the third time. The Arden bench looking on.
There's Alex James in the Campion goal. Looking on at his fellow custodian. Alex James so far with 5 clean sheets in the competition. There's Nikolai Banton, who put Campion in front in this contest with his second of the season. Let's see what he can serve up from this corner kick.
Corner kick sent inside. Try again to send it one side the box. Banton, that's a good delivery. He was trying to nod it back to his keeper, you know, but That was off target.
And Campaign go again with a corner.
There's a delivery again. A lot on it. And there's a clash of heads. Jazless is all right. It is Sean Reed who is down. What a name the number 10 has. He was playing for Campion College last year, Jazless.
Yeah.
It's an interesting name. His brother would have played for Jamaica College a few years back. I was mentioning as we take a look at the corner kick again and exactly what took place inside the box, and you'll see the collision there. I'm saying that Jazless has the name of a musician, but his brother, Elijah, is actually the musician in the family.
Maybe he's musically inclined as well.
No, well, maybe, but he's definitely for the football.
Yeah, really rangy player.
I saw what he did there. Well played, Lish.
Played like a musician. Who says Arden didn't teach you anything, Dada?
Less. Trying to serve that one forward, but couldn't on that occasion.
Yeah, good work in the end there by Mohamed. And Campion recycle again.
Banton. That's a lovely ball inside. Oh, yeah, the time and space, you know. Decided to go first time with the effort, Matthew Rule.
Yeah, tried for the fancy finish as opposed to the normal one. Probably should have controlled that one, Matthew Rule.
Yeah, he wasn't in charge of the situation, was he?
Campion remain in charge of this game, however. Unless Arden can do something about it. Not like that.
No, not at all. Banton. Oh, that's delightful skill. Trying to thread that through again. The pass inside the area. The Bayesian has some skill about him.
Yeah, smiling like that, he knows. A couple players of Bayesian descent in the Manning Cup this season. Isaiah Stibel from Jamaica College as well. To see Arden take over now. Yeah, so international flair to the competition this season.
This one is hoisted long. Lloyd couldn't reach it. Oh, that's a lovely ball spread through. The keeper is off his line. An opportunity still for Arden inside the box, and well, he went down belatedly. And the referee saw nothing doing there.
Yeah, chance for Arden and their striker, Nashan Reed, to stretch his legs. It wasn't the best of finishes. Oh, and that's a penalty, you know. Trying to work out which Campion defender it was that was late.
Oh.
Jadeen Morgan.
The shot from distance. And James gathering. But yeah, that was a clear penalty, actually.
Yeah, and I saw the referee looking to his assistant to double check. So the referee nor his assistant could get that one right.
Some strange calls have been in this game. Really some strange calls. Here it goes the other way. And it's still on the turf. Oh, they've managed to clear. Harden high, and they're trying to break away now. Ball played into space. Reed is on it. Reed. His effort is blocked. Another opportunity here for Arden. Moving into space. Needed a passing option. Back to Reed. There's an element of slow motion in this game that I can't really put my finger on it. But I'm not sure the players are weary, but not quite playing at top speed. Reed delivers straight into the hands of Alex James. Rule. Still has it, Rule. Sends it out wide. Less than 5 minutes to go in the first half. Arden trying to get the equalizer, but again they have lost possession in a critical area. That ball from Jazzless was put into space, and well, the flag was up for offside at any rate.
Yeah. Those two strikers, really an out ball for Campion. There you have the support from Hope Road coming along. Ready strong. It is indeed. Some past students as well.
Here's Arden. Candy inside, and now turned all the way back to Jevon Jackson. Referee says play on, and finally the whistle is blown. Slalin appears to be all right, but he has to come off the field. But Arden will still have the possession, the free kick, I think. Free kick for Arden. Straight into the wall. I think they're appreciating staying in the shade. Now here's Les. Jazz Les going forward. Bits of stoppages to be played, Liz.
Arden looking to make the most of it. Pressing to get that equalizer. Last time these two teams were in a group together, they split the wins one each. Arden winning the first encounter, and then Campion getting the second. In 2019, first real year where we saw marked improvement by Campion.
Kick taken to the edge of the box for Arden, still looking for that equalizer. But we have seen a lack of urgency in the last few minutes by both teams, and I think probably the sun and the heat is just managing to take a toll on both sets of players. Yeah, pretty much. Good movement by Campion.
Lot of old boys there on the bench for Campion. All of their coaching staff, bar Eric Rademakers, who isn't here today, played Manning Cup for the school.
Yeah, Rademakers should by now be arriving back in the island after going overseas on tour with a few members of his academy. Henry does really well, sends this one across. Couldn't find a fellow Campionite. So just a last few seconds here of the first half in stoppage time. Yep, comes to an end now. Just the one goal in it. Hasn't been the most interesting football game of the season. But in this clash, which has been dubbed the Upton Derby, it's Campion College with the advantage, courtesy of a Nikolai Banton goal in the opening period of this one, and registering his second goal of the season from the penalty spot. Campion College with the advantage.
Second of our Zone F clashes here at Winchester Park, and it's Campion College leading this one 1-0 over Arden High. Campion looking to give themselves an even firmer position in this Zone F, and they did so with a really good start. It was Matthew Lloyd racing through, put the ball in the back of the net, but the referee had called for a penalty first. I'm not quite sure for what to this point, but he chalked off the goal. And instead of Matthew Lloyd getting on the score sheet, it was Nikolai Banton instead. It was the same result, a Campion College goal. Just less stung the palms of Adlam in the Arden goal on a couple occasions, actually. Rangy midfielder from Campion took one with his left foot as well. He has been Adlam's most prominent enemy in that first half. Arden created a couple of chances though. This, I think, the biggest of them. Nashawn Reed racing through. Couldn't apply the finish, and I think that should have been a penalty for Arden, actually. Morgan for Campion. I think stepping on the back of the foot of Brandon Banton. And that's all she wrote for the first half. Statistics coming up. Not a lot of shots in this one. 9 combined for both teams, but Campion have all 4 of theirs on target and the 1 goal. 2 shots on target for Arden. 3 fouls apiece. No yellows, no reds. 2 offsides for Campion. They're also shading the corner count. Basically the same amount of saves for each keeper. 3 for Adlam, however. The possession also relatively even, but just like the possession which Campion is shading, they're also shading the result as well. They have the all-important 1 goal in this one. Jene, I know a lot of fans are not here like the first game, but I'm sure you found some.
Definitely, Jay. I'm here in the stands with the fans. Some fans from Arden. These are some girls. Girls, tell me, do you guys know anything about football?
A lot. I know a lot about football.
Tell me one thing about football.
That number 10 is probably the best player on the field.
What's his name?
Oh, not my number 10, but Denzel.
The number 10, Denzel Allen, my best friend. I love you.
Okay, guys. So you guys aren't leading at the moment, but do you think that Arden will come out victorious in today's match?
I think Arden tends to show their cards later in the game, so they definitely come out on top later.
Okay, well, I had a talk with you earlier. You talked to me about the fact that Arden has accepted the fact that they aren't going to make it out to the group stage, but they still came out here and fight. Tell me the mindset of the boys.
So basically, we don't really have anything left to fight for. So it's really just about pride and really ending the season on a high and upsetting our rivals and ruining their season just like how ours is out the window. So yeah, we just have to fight for whatever pride we have left. So yeah.
Well, I can't talk to Arden and not talk to Campion. This is the mother of one of the players on the field. I want you to tell me his name and the number that he wears.
Marquis Steele is number 5.
You told me that you made this poster. He didn't want you to bring it, but as a mom, you brought it. Tell me what you think the scoreline will be for today.
At least 4-0. Nothing for Arden today.
But you told me 6-1 earlier.
No, they're not even scoring 1.
Okay. Well, let me see the sign. Well, there you have it. We're in the stands with both Campion and Arden. We have a lot more football action for you after the break.
We'll be right back.
Nations League is on your home of champions this week, and there are a couple of matches that we have set for you. And they will be on time on Thursday. St. Martin against St. Kitts, 2 p.m., 3 p.m. Eastern Caribbean time on Sportsmax. And Also on Thursday, Suriname against Haiti on Sportsmax 2 beginning at 5 p.m., 6 p.m. ECT. And the Reggae Boys against the Spice Boys, Grenada, hosting Jamaica at 6 p.m., 7 p.m. ECT right after the Sportsmax zone on Sportsmax. And then at 8 o'clock, Cuba against Honduras, 8 p.m. Jamaica time, 9 p.m. ECT. You can watch that match free on Sportsmax Plus, which is on the Sportsmax app. Download it today, by the way, to keep in touch with a lot of the sporting action all across the world. Thank you and welcome back to Winchester Park, St. George, Campion College against Arden High. And Campion with the advantage, 1-0 after 45 minutes. We begin the second half now. Campion in red and white if you're just joining us. And Arden High in blue and yellow. Lejay Williams is still with me. It wasn't the most exciting first half. You suspect that any semblance of normalcy will see a better second half in this one.
Yeah, I think both of these teams, as Arden fan mentioned, that Arden like to finish strong. I know Campion like to finish strong as well. A lot of second half goals in their season, so hopefully that will they'll come with a bit more attacking thrust, both teams, and really force the issue in the second half.
Yeah, it was becoming pedestrian by the end of that first stanza between both teams. I'm wondering if the heat got to them just a little bit as a free kick for Arden. This one is sent inside the area at the back post, and well, there's nobody there, right? That has gone out for a goal kick. So Arden still pressing for that equalizer. Ambitious effort to take that one first time. Well over the top.
Yeah, Nobushi there trying to take matters into his own hands. Not the best of efforts, however. Has been practically everywhere in that midfield for Arden so far, Doshi.
White slipping that one through. Oh, that's a lovely switch of play there. First touch wasn't the best, but they still have a big chance. It goes behind for a corner kick. It was a canby again inside the box. He was arriving just in time. Would have wanted a better first touch to really create that big opportunity for the Ardenites, but it is a corner kick, and yeah, they are sending bodies forward.
Yeah, I think the touch that he took really took away the space that he might have had had he controlled it well, but they do have a corner here.
Here it comes. It's a wasted one.
Yeah, especially seeing that Arden is the bigger team. I think that they would have wanted a better delivery on that occasion.
Both teams for me appear to be a little bit too slight in their passing, in their 50-50 battles, in their running as well. almost as if they are playing within themselves. Like, even with the challenges, not a lot in there. And you get the feeling that they could easily be bullied by other opposition. Campion. See what I mean? Just a little bit too slight. Too much of feathery touches and movement. And because of that, you can sense the lack of potency in their attacks and also in their defending as well, if we are to be honest. For Campion College, you can understand there are a few 14-year-olds and 15-year-olds in there. Arden High, also a pretty young team, but obviously bigger physically. But it does make the game a little bit unattractive, what we've seen so far. Both teams not quite taking the fight to the opposition.
Yeah, I do get your point about the team playing within themselves, both teams. See Matthew Rule there getting some treatment on his calf. Riding with some support close by. Well, closer than you are, Donald. I know.
I was just wondering what you meant.
I'm in the sixth formers that have made their way down here to Winchester Park.
And there are quite a few sixth formers in the crowd as well. Would be disappointed with the score at the moment.
So that's a time to change that score, however.
They have had their chances, don't it? Touch to get by his marker and then deciding to take the shot. Was never in control of the situation. Dio Duque Quarry of Tima. The motto, with God as guide, we seek the best and the highest.
Are you putting me on the spot to say Campion's motto?
No, if you will.
Fortis in fide et opere.
Which means?
Steadfast in faith and good work.
That's wonderful. It really is.
Yeah, I left school much more recently than you did, so it's still fresh in the brain.
Obviously, Arden had more of an impact on my life than Campion did on yours, but I understand.
Well, just like how Campion are having much more of an impact on the scoreline.
Only the scoreline. Campion defending. As Arden trying to press in the attack in third.
Press is a bit of a stretch, but
here they are with it, and the shot is a little bit wayward. just a tad wayward by Denzel Allen.
I've never heard you this kind.
I think it's the first time I'm doing an Arden game. Next time we should go to Arden.
I think you need a field to play football at first. It's a foul here for Campion.
Come on. So Campion will have a free kick at an angle here. Nikolai Banton, who's been behind most set pieces, is again set to take this one. He's already scored in this game from the penalty spot, the Bayesian. That was his second goal this season. What can he do from much further out? Lofted inside the box, not clear properly. Opportunity at the back post, couldn't guide it goalwards, but the flag had gone up for offside.
That's Sean Reed over there that needs a little bit of help. It was actually David Akanbi on that side.
Down to 10 players for the moment, Arden. The Arden players are going down like flies right now. Probably it's a cramped situation. Yeah, I know that reaction very well. Allen now getting the attention. Every year we speak about hydration and nutrition, and we'll keep on stressing that hydration is not just about drinking a lot of water on the day, it's all about the lifestyle as well. And that's his last bit of action for the day, Denzel Allen. Stretcher is being called upon. Dante Lewin is getting ready to come on. Thank you. What's a treatment for cramp, though? Just ice? I heard a thing that if you put something between your toes, that it eases the pain as well. It works.
I mean, you're telling me.
Okay. But what are the other things that you do as we see the sub being made, Lewin coming on?
Personally, I just tough it out.
Ah, okay.
If it is indeed a cramp, then it will subside eventually, but looks like a pretty serious one. In the case of Arden player, had to be subbed off.
No, I kid you not. Sometimes a pen does a trick. Just grip a couple of toes together around a pen and it eases the pain sometimes.
Well, that's an interesting attempt at a shot. Bravin Bell.
Well, what's happening here now?
Maybe after effects of his earlier injury. It can be.
Too close for comfort still, he'll be thinking.
Yeah, I think so. Especially considering the positions of both teams in the group.
Yeah, Kempion College would want to capitalize well on the fact that Jose Marti did lose to St. George's College earlier in the day, and by big two, 7-2. Now, Lejay, talk me through this, because this was converted. The whistle blew before the shot was taken and a penalty was awarded. Up to now, I have no idea what happened, but it was converted.
Yeah, you're asking the wrong guy. I'm not quite sure what was the ruling or why the penalty was given. But as I said, penalty was scored in the end. They chalked off a goal for Campion and gave a penalty instead, and because the penalty was scored, I guess you can say it was just what was meant to happen. Goal was scored, same result.
David Akanbi is now going to come off. Jamari Sangster, who has 3 goals to his name, is coming on. Should have done better from that position there, Dante Lewin. Lovely turn of pace there. But a free kick awarded.
I think it was for the initial tackle, although it didn't take out Matthew Lloyd. Can say it did impede him. I know it's going to be Banton again to try and swing this one in for Campion.
Lofted inside the area, almost a free header there, but just evaded. Diaz Jazlez. Looking for his third goal this season.
Yeah, that was a really good delivery, and I think Jazz was just a little bit too slow to get an end of that one. Once again from set pieces, Campion looking dangerous.
Nicely done. Knocked into space. That was really easy for Alex James. Ball over the top, headed away. Banton trying to win it but couldn't. Lovely touch away from his marker. Going into second gear. Trying to take the ball with him. Still has it. Going to the byline. Not sure if that was the right choice, but he does earn a corner kick for his team. Sean Reed. Doing a lot of work for Arden over on that side.
As if we're going to get our second water break of the afternoon. There are around 22 minutes left in this one, a halfway point in the second half. Campion College still leading by a goal to nil in this zone F clash against Arden. Yes, while we have the break, I can just talk about the improvements in Campion's fortunes over the years. As a former Campionite myself, I've seen some pretty dismal times in our school football program. A couple bright sparks, of course, but a lot of dismal times. I remember the year after I left in 2015, the school conceded in excess of 50 goals in the group stage without scoring any. And since then, when Kingston Football Academy began in 2017 onwards, it was 38 in 2017, 25 in 2018, and then in 2019 it was 22. And then after not competing in the COVID season, we saw a drastic drop in 2021, where they only conceded 6 in the group stage. Now we're seeing them here having only conceded in one game so far out of their 7. They're relatively close to the end of their 7th game. Only 2 goals conceded, one of the best defensive records. So although I don't think that they have the high-level attacking talent in the school to go along with the high-level coaching anymore, because we have seen some high-level attacking talent go through Campion. A lot of players getting double-digit goals and assists in the under-16 level, under-14 level. I get more onto that in a little while as Arden are here on the attack.
Here's an opportunity. Goes to place it back. Dorsey again. Not able to manufacture the space. Arden as yet. Lewin trying to send that one inside. Corner kick. There's a corner kick. Keeper was an easy catch there in his own 6-yard box.
Kempen clearing this one.
Ball slipped through. An opportunity here for Arden. This one, brilliant save. Wonderful block nearby. Adlam it was. And Jazz Les was the one who hit that one. And there was some power behind it, but Adlam pulled out a fine stop.
Yeah, it was a good attempt by Jazz Les. Campion seeing that one out, but that was a good attempt. Good chance for Campion to extend their lead, but it wasn't taken. Got a lot of power on the shot. Was in the direction of the goalkeeper, so it's a save that he should have made, but often we've seen that one go through schoolboy keepers. So it's a good stop. Really good stop. Firm, firm hand.
Banton has won it. Les picks it up.
Matthew
nice
Rule
turn
again.
Really from Rule. Trying to cap it off with a long range shot.
That's a poor challenge.
Yellow card is being shown. Yeah, it's been shown to Doshi, I believe. Or no, is it Jackson?
Yeah, Javon Jackson.
Yeah, for that challenge.
It's going to be yet another free kick for Campion, loading the box. Banton again to swing it in.
6 players inside the box for Campion College.
Call it 7 now. They've certainly loaded it.
Banton trying to find a teammate here. Sent inside the area. Still an opportunity, but the keeper holds on. Adlam again.
Has really dug Arden out of some holes today, Adlam.
It's been that kind of game where he's easily in the discussion for player of the game, Adlam.
Yeah, yeah, I think so. So too this one on the ball, Banton.
Here's an opportunity. Oh, lovely run this is.
Yeah, I thought that was a foul. Referee obliged. Yeah, poor challenge, actually. I was making a point earlier about some of the talent that has passed through Campion, especially since we started struggling. I just don't think that there was a proper structure to capitalize on that talent. There is now. That's why we're seeing the fruits of the labor, a couple substitutes coming on.
Yeah, Banton is being taken off now.
So too, Jazzless. Going to see David Thompson.
Yeah, he already has a couple of goals to his name.
And Cameron Mayhew.
The younger brother to Brian, who was a part of the midfield last year.
Yeah, before sustaining a season-ending injury. Brian.
But he's also in the States as well.
Yeah.
And Cameron Mayhew is only 14 years old.
Another one of the young players for Campion.
David, one.
Arden with a free kick here.
Small sent over the top.
Yeah, I think this would afford me an opportunity to finally get to what I was saying about the talent coming through. Hopefully, at least. But yeah, in the last decade or so, we've seen Campion produce players. Well, not the best kick out there. Campion have won it, but produce players that have won in the Valencia camp, where Valencia come and take players with them to Spain. We've seen three Campionites win that competition and go on. The likes of Chad James now at Mount Pleasant, Devon Duckworth, Luca Levy, who represented Jamaica at the national level, the senior team. We've seen players who have done really well in the club system in Jamaica as well. Talk about Jaheim Nelson, top scorer in under 13 competition for Harbor View, which they won a couple years ago. You talk about Dondre Bennett, who excelled for Mabé United a couple years ago when they were excelling in the Unders program. Former captains like Daniel Lala, Jason Leslie, who is now a schoolboy football analyst. So a lot of talent has passed through Campion, but never the right structure, never the right program for them to succeed. So I'm really glad as a former Campionite to see that structure that Coach Ashton Blanks and Eric Rademakers, even Coach Brian Philpotts-Brown, who's still included in it as well, really pushing that program forward and providing success, not only on an improvement level, but also on a success level, bringing home a trophy, the first football trophy in Campion's history, to the school last season. But more importantly today, let's see if they can hold on to this lead in this game. Arden will have to do a lot of work to breach this defense, which has seen only two times it's been breached this season. And Alex James comes and claims this one comfortably, looking to have his sixth clean sheet of the season, which would actually be tied for the most in the Money Cup this season. Bit of frustration seeping into the Arden ranks. But I've talked a while about Champion Donnelly. Care to share some stuff about Arden?
We won the Money Cup in 1991. And Champion trying to... And the World Cup. It was a double. And I reckon it's something that Campion could only dream of at the moment. Here's Arden. Again, trying to make it into the attacking third. But it's good to see Campion embracing the tag of being an all-round school. I did mention my concern that it is going to be difficult for them to have a team together for 3 or 4 years. We did mention the likes of Kai Miles and Brian Mayhew, two of their top stars last season, not coming back this year due to other educational opportunities overseas. And they were, 14 and 15?
Yeah. Especially Kai Miles, is disappointing to see him go. Was the captain for Jamaica under 15 in the recent foray in the CONCACAF Championship. A team that reached to the knockout stages for the first time in Jamaica's history. So that just goes to show the talent that Kai Miles has. Talent that led Campion last year. I'm sure they would have loved to have him this, but are then making a couple of changes now.
And Sean Reed comes on. Joshua Wilson has come on. So too Gabriel Clark. Here's Arden again coming forward. Battle of wills on the edge of the box there. Campion coming out on top. Arden regain possession in the shadows and sends this one straight to goalkeeper Alex James. Oh, they've lost it in a dangerous spot. James has lost it. The whistle goes. Sangster committing the foul.
Yeah, didn't finish anyhow.
Or was it Reed rather? Yeah, Nashawn Reed.
Not quite sure where the infringement was. Oh, there it is. Yeah, kicking the ball out of the goalkeeper's hand. Didn't finish anyhow, so no harm, no foul in the end.
Well, there was the foul.
And holding on. Still.
All in all, you probably, Arden will probably look back at this game and consider themselves to be unfortunate. In my opinion, there was a clear foul inside the box that should have been awarded a penalty. John Adlam putting off a really good save here. And brilliantly done, moving to his left and digging that one out. The shot from Jazz Les. And it went behind for a corner kick, but a good hit, a wonderful save, low down to his left there, denying Campion College a second goal. Of course, remember to download the Sportsmax app and watch Schoolboy Football for free on Sportsmax Plus. So I don't think a lot of time will be added for stoppages. Well, we're about 4 minutes away from stoppage time. As here is Arden. Lovely ball out left. Just one player inside the box at the moment. And trying to find him was always going to be a task. But even then, it was not the best delivery at all. Another change is happening. Matthew Lloyd is off. Jabari Pettigrew is on. Well. Yeah, so Brandt comes on for Lloyd. Pettigrew and Brandt are on. That time of the game. Well, we talk about the man of the match, but Jazz Les coming through. The keeper is out. And he came out at the right time again, did John Adlam. Oh, that's a lovely delivery, but couldn't quite control that one. And it goes the other way, Les. Oh, that's lovely. Trying to get the shot off on that occasion was Brandt. That's a similar gate to Les. Does Derek Brandt looking for his first goal.
Still toiling away.
So Arden trying to get back into this game, Campion. Trying to see what the final few minutes here with the one goal advantage. Oh, that's a lovely win there. That one is touched into space, but Campion with the clearance. Well, Ball allowed to go through. Thinking of a shot, and it's wide of the mark. So time for that man of the match discussion. Well, I was talking earlier about the opportunities for Arden, few and far between, but that had to be a penalty, Leger, in the first half.
Yeah, it definitely had to be. Referee was blind to it, however, the referees not given. And in the end, it denied Arden a chance to seriously get back in this game. Yeah, he asked about the man of the match. It has been the most fluid of attacking performances. Therefore, neither defense has had to do too much. John Adlam has been good in the Arden goal, making a few saves, but I think my man of the match would go to Nikolai Banton of Campion, the goal scorer. Solid performance in the midfield.
Yep. I think I'd probably have to agree with you, although he has been relatively quiet in the second half. Banton. And he did come off pretty early in the second half. It's difficult to have an argument against what you said, because there haven't really been many standouts in the game. So, yeah. Banton. I won't argue against that one.
For once.
Unless something happens here now. Oh, he goes to the byline, but the keeper should collect that one easily, and he does. Alex James.
Yeah, Doshi has been trying his hardest to make things happen for Arden. Just not to be so far. He still has around 2 minutes.
Midway through stoppage time. What has the Uptown Derby mean to you, Leger Williams?
Well, I'd actually like to clarify this on here. Oh, that's a tough tackle, but the actual Uptown Derby, from when I was going to school at least, was Campion versus Hillel, a game or a series of games that they would play each year. I think, I'm not sure if most people consider Arden as Uptown, but for the sake of this broadcast and this production, it has been the best game, but it seems as if we're getting the right result, which is a better team getting all 3 points.
Ethan Brown has made his way on the park as well for Campion College. He has about a minute to play as Arden lofts this one, and he goes out in touch for a goal kick to Campion College. There is some argument that Arden High isn't really Uptown, but I will just say that Arden High are the best mannered students in the country, I believe. As here they are looking for the equalizer. The flag, I believe, has gone up. No, it has actually stayed down. Arden with the possession. Desperately looking for that equalizer. Sangster. Can they do something with this attack? Heading to the byline, needs to pull across inside, and it goes behind for a corner kick. Last chance saloon for Arden High. Can they get the equalizer with this set piece? It's best to try and commit as many bodies forward. Here's the delivery from Sangster. An opportunity inside the box. It's blocked. And Campion, they're just able to clear. Well, that was the final big opportunity. And Campion College, they barely survive. And in the end, they have eked out the victory only just by a goal to nil And it was from the penalty spot. They are friends after all of this. But Campion College gain a valuable 3 points here. Arden High, they had their moments. Can be argued that they should have had a penalty as well. Didn't go in their favor. And they'll have to think about it. And the missed opportunities again tonight. But Adlam was outstanding. But Campion College with the bragging rights at the end of 90 minutes. As I take a look at the full-time highlights here from Winchester Park. Ball sent inside the box. And this was a legitimately good goal, I felt, but the referee saw something, had blown the whistle, and then pointed to the spot. In the fourth minute, Banton converted. The Bayesian with his second goal this season from the penalty spot, and the Campion with an early lead. Campion kept firing on target. Adlam was equal to the task. At times, he even got injured in the process. That was a fabulous save, you know, from Adlam, moving smartly to his left, denying Jazz Less. And Adlam putting that one around the post. This one played through. And I felt that should have been a penalty. Was cut down inside the box. And the referee apparently did not see it. Then in the second half, Banton service inside looking for Jazz Less. It just evaded him. He knew it was pretty close, but he was arriving late there. Campion could have added, but Adlam again with a fabulous hand on it. It was Jazz Less again with the hit. And Adlam with a strong right hand. And then right at the end, a shot that was blocked. Goal saving. Yeah. It was going on target, but it was blocked inside the area. And Campion held on. Campion College with 5 shots, 5 on target. Arden High with 9 shots. Just 3 on target, however. That's 13 fouls committed in the game, and 3 corner kicks apiece. And it was 50-50 the possession at the end of that contest. It's now time for the Dinsdale man of the match. He's with Jene and our good friend Kadeen Webley.
Congratulations, Nikolai Banton. He's been presenting the Digicel Man of the Match Award by Kadeen Webley, the junior brand manager of Digicel. Thank you, Kadeen. Nikolai, this is your second goal of the season. We had a talk before you came on camera. You told me how you felt before you took that penalty. Tell the camera how you felt.
First, I have to thank God that I scored. But I put in the work on the training ground. I'm just glad I converted. But yeah, I was a bit nervous going into it, but I knew what I had to do.
Well, you came off relatively early in the second half. Was there anything that resulted in the coach taking you off?
I had a bit of a cramp in my leg, but at the end of the day, it's just what he thought was best to get the win, which we did.
Okay, how confident are you with Campion College this season?
Yeah, we're unbeaten in 5 games, I think, so we're going really well, but I think we still haven't reached our best. We haven't lived up to our coach's expectations yet.
Okay, well, congratulations and thank you.
All right, thank you.
And now we'll welcome Coach Lloyd Terrelong, the coach of Arden High School. Coach, you haven't managed to make it out to the group stage, but you showed up today and you had a decent performance. How have you managed to keep the boys motivated?
Well, we have a rival with Campion over the years before I was at Arden, so the boys were motivated to play Campion today.
Well, coach, you won the Manning Cup back in 1991. With the current program that you have today, do you think that some way, somehow, Arden will get back to that place of winning our next Manning Cup?
We have a good training program and a good system now put in place. So next year we'll see the fruits of that.
Well, I saw a lot of Ardenites out here today. How supportive is the Arden alumni amidst the lack of progress in the group stage?
They're still with the team, you know, because we're reaching there.
Okay, well, coach, you have one more game to go. How do you sum up your season so far?
It's not a bad season. The ups and downs got a whole heap of injury, but we'll pull through.
Okay, well, thank you, coach.
Thank you, Mitch.
And now we welcome the head coach of Campion College. Coach, you're second on the table. You managed to score early in today's game. How pleased are you with today's result?
I mean, we're happy with the result. A little disappointed with the performance. I think we have some young players getting used to playing on TV and even in the Manning Cup. So we're proud of them. But yesterday, have some things to work on.
Well, coach, we see the absence of last year's standout, Kai Miles. Do you think that there's a gap in the team this year? And if so, was that gap visible today?
I mean, we lost about six of our starters from last season. I think they get a lot of opportunities overseas. But we just have the next player moving up, so we have more 14, 15-year-olds coming up. And I think they've done well so far. We're second in the table.
Well, coach, let's talk on a positive note. Campions program has shown improvement in the recent years. What are some of the attributes you are seeing coming to the forefront this season?
I mean, we see the players get a lot more comfortable on the field. I think they are more confident. I think even a little bit too confident, as you saw today. But you see, it's just getting the kids playing a lot more football through our academy. But even in the school program, all the boys play a lot of football throughout the year, and it's now showing.
Well, thank you, coach. Congratulations.
All right, thanks so
much. So, the two results in Zone F. St. George's College with a 7-2 win over the Mighty Campion College with a 1-0 victory over Arden. And based on the standings now, we see St. George's College with a perfect 7-7, a 38 goal difference on 21 points. Campion College 5 points behind, and Jose Marti in third spot on 12 points. Waterford in 7 and Arden on 3, the only other teams with points on the table. It's the Costa Cup action live on your home of champions on Friday. We will be in Portland, Titchfield, against Port Antonio High at 2:30 p.m., 3:30 in the Eastern Caribbean. You can watch it on Sportsmax Plus. And then on Saturday, we'll see the Carteret College against Mayday, 1 p.m., 2 p.m. in the Eastern Caribbean. And that's going to be on Sportsmax 2 and Sportsmax Plus. And right after that, Manchester High against Belier, 3 p.m., 4 p.m. in the Eastern Caribbean. The SSFL is on Sportsmax 2. Catch it live Wednesday afternoon, 3:30 TNT time, 2:30 in Jamaica, Fatima College against Queen's Royal College. That's a big matchup. You don't want to miss that one. So, final score here. It is Campion College with a 1-0 win over Arden. And they're second in the group. One of the groups in this ISSA Manning Cup competition. Campion getting all 3 points over Arden after St. George's College won their game against Jose Marti. That's it for coverage here from Winchester Park. On behalf of the hard-working production team, my producer Philip Riley, director Daniel Allen, goodness me, almost got it wrong there. I'm Donald Oliver, signing out from St. George's College.
Yo, Issa, our schoolboy football look this season. People, I'm ready, you know. All right, then, Pico, Manning Cup, Olivia Shield, yo, make we link up to watch the Champions Cup, Ben Francis, Water Cup, which team I win the championship this season? Yo, Issa, one dive at school, I got finish the league and beat, no. Which youth I got collect the golden boot and be the favorite for the people? Yo, Issa, busy fans are roll out all about the flag pan vehicle. Looking at the crowd, bus load of supporters from school and community. People nothing at the stand, some a listen to and read the bus, some a watch it on TV too. Country and town unite for one reason. Issa's
competition, I never have it nice. People love see when boy I get nice up on the field. I'm gonna score from far and them level with peaceful and the youths now. Yo, it's a schoolboy football, no local. The youths are moving to international big league. And I steal people hard, but member wish party start. It's a schoolboy football, come come, look one, look all. Which team are the best and like a better than the rest? And if I hear team beat your chest, it's a schoolboy football. A team could rise and a team could fall. But they never will know until the whistle blows. So run, come enjoy the show.